Hello?
Hello, is this Cynthia?
Yeah, this is Althea. Shalom, how are you?
Amen. How you doing?
How are you?
I'm just great. And yourself?
I was browsing YouTube yesterday, and I keep the Sabbath, so it was yesterday after the Sabbath. I was browsing YouTube, and when I browse, I put in the word. I think I put in deliverance. Let me see what I put in. Prayer points for spiritual warfare. I think that's what I put in.
You said you put in what word?
Prayer points for spiritual warfare.
Okay.
And you popped up. I put in spiritual warfare prayer points. It's one of those two.
Okay. Yeah, because
And I said, let me listen to what she has to say. And I listen. And I'm telling you blesses me.
now, can you recall which video message you listened to?
I listened to, well, let me tell you what I did. Last night, I listened to the one where you said deliverance from spiritual husband.
Right.
But when I listened to it, you blesses me. So I was doing everything because I have to give you this testimony.
Okay.
What happened, I was facing a lot of, like a fear of the unknown because in the last 9 years, I buried five of my family member. And when it happened, after that, I came down with colon cancer, and after my colon cancer operation, I buried my sister 6, 7 months ago. And then and I have her kids, and I'm, you know, her kids are here with me, you know, I have the kids, and I'm living with me. So I said, what's going on in my family? And, you know, sometimes you tell people, and they look at you like you probably did something
Yeah.
so wrong, and, you know,
Right.
God is getting back at you. And I know I've done wrong, but it's not that kind of what
Right.
they'll be thinking, you know?
Right.
Yeah, so I said, God, what is going on? Talk to me, but you know, you want to hear that still voice, but the answers you're seeking, maybe you're not ready for it, or maybe you're not prepared to hear it. That's something I can't seem to hear. So I said, you know, 6 years ago I got saved. When I saw that I lost my brother back, one brother, the next year I lost another brother. Then, yeah, and then the other year I lost my mom, then my father. I said, no, what's going on? And then after I lost my dad, the next year I came up with colon cancer. I was sick, I came up to 90 pounds. I had to wear a wound back on my stomach. Then I developed a hematoma and the surgery came apart. Everything was coming out of my stomach. I said, my goodness, what is going on? I remember like I got 9 blood transfusions. And through it all, God kept me. I was out for like 7 months from work. I went back to work. When I went back to work, the next year I lost my sister, which was last year, September. I buried her. And then I went to bury my sister. I bring the body back to Connecticut. When I came back, I lost my job. Then I ended up with the kids. I said, what is going on? So, you know, I was just, when I listen to you, it blesses me. But I listen to the only two I haven't listened to is unhealthy soul ties and how to keep your deliverance. But so far, everything that you have done, all the testimonies, I sat the whole morning last night. I went to bed at 3 o'clock listening to you. And I got up this morning, and when I got up this morning, I made something to eat, and I put the computer back on, and I listened to you till about 2 hours ago. I signed you off. I have two more to listen to because you blessed my spirit. And
Amen.
you taught me something that soul ties is not for the one who's not married. So all this, no, the spiritual husband is for not it's for the people who are not married, but incubus and succubus are for the
Right.
single people.
Right.
So I learned something. I said, this woman blesses me, and you have a clean spirit about you.
Amen.
I said, I gotta listen to her because I feel like what you were trying to form to me, it was clean.
Amen.
When I did the prayer point with you last night, I felt a deliverance I never had because
Amen.
I always had a fear. Yes, I have to tell you, last time I lay here, and you didn't want a deliverance from spiritual husband, but what you were given was, the prayer points was doing the forgiveness
Right.
and repenting, and I did repentance, and the way I did it was like a repentance from my belly coming all the way up.
Amen.
And when I did it, I felt something I never felt, and listen, I always had the spirit of fear, of the unknown, like dying, all that kind of stuff. Always, when I close my eyes up, it's like it's what I see. And I said, listen, when I did the prayer point with you, I am telling you, Evangelist King, I do not fear on God or anything. I haven't had it.
Amen. Glory to God.
Listen, I would be scared to lay down. I'm not going to get up. There's a fear over me. Like, I give the fear take over. So let me take over to my heart. Panic. I said, oh, my God, what is going on? And I'm telling you, Evangelist King, when I just had a prayer point with you last night, I went to bed and I slept like a baby, and I never had the fear of dying. I never had the fear of anything coming over me. It's like it's gone.
Glory, glory, glory. God is so good. He is good.
I had to listen, because I got deliverance, so people prayed for me about it. That they see me worrying about dying, and they see the fear of death over me because the enemy is trying to take me out. But when I tell you, yes, but when even last week a man prophesied to me from Ghana, and he prophesied to me, so the enemy trying to take you out, because I feel like the only one in the family left to get the other family member delivered is you, so they're trying to get you out. You're the only one who will save. He told me that. I said, the devil is a liar.
Amen, amen, amen.
Well, listen, when I prayed for me, and I never felt what I felt when I did the prayer points with you last night.
Jesus.
Something left me, and I'm telling you, when I got up this morning, I was talking to God. I said, God, I don't have that fear of that. And listen, the whole day I sit today, I don't see that death coming in front of me. I don't see that when I close my eyes. I don't see it.
Amen. God set you free.
Jesus.
Because he said, once you know the truth, that you know is what will set you free. And when the Lord opened up your spiritual understanding to the truth,
Jesus,
as to what it is that has been tormenting you, bothering you, and he gave you spiritual insight into that matter,
yes,
and then he went and showed you what you needed to do, you were set free.
Yes. Oh, my God. I said, this woman's spirit is clean.
Glory,
I said, it has to be, because all the other people who prayed for me were people like from Africa.
Uh-huh.
And I said, this is the first time, this is an American woman praying for me. And I'm not saying your spirit is not clean, but
okay,
there's something about you that the Holy Spirit tell me your spirit
glory,
was clean, and that's
glory,
what happened.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus.
I thank God, because we can't choose who God will work through to give us our deliverance. It's up to Him.
Yes.
It's up to Him, but we have to have the willingness to receive who He have chosen
Jesus,
to help
Jesus.
Us. Now, suppose you would say, well, she's not a native African. I want my people to help me. You wouldn't have been free this day, because we cannot dictate to the Lord who He used.
And the Holy Spirit out there, maybe He said, like the Holy Spirit said to me, the people who you went to, not because they're sound, it sounds real. That doesn't mean their life is clean.
Go ahead, girl!
Jesus.
Just because they
Jesus.
Sound like it ain't gonna cut
Jesus.
It. Glory
because it doesn't mean that spirit is clean. So when they penetrate into your praying for you from the spirit of death, spirit is not clean to deliver you.
Glory to
I
God.
I said, oh my, this one in the kitchen, the Holy Spirit was talking to me. Evangelist, I closed my eyes and I did not see that. Each time I closed my eyes, I thought I'd see it. I said, the devil is a liar. I will not die but live and declare the work of the Lord.
Woo, this is all right. Thank you for these encouragements. Thank you for letting me know what's going on, because it's a great encouragement to me. Wow, God is good. He is so, so good. He heard your cry.
I laid down and I said, God, I said to God, I'm going to renounce everything that I've ever done. This is what this woman is saying. I'm going to renounce them one at a time. And I renounce them single by single by single from my belly. I did it. I said, God, I open myself to you. Come in. I receive you. I said, I've got to be delivered from this spirit. This spirit is not going to take me down before my time. I got God work to do. I said, Father, I shall not die but live. My family member will be saved. And I was doing. And when you hit that prayer point, I start with you. I speak with you.
Go ahead.
1 o'clock I was up, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock I went to bed and I shut the door. And I just went, I was back with you again.
Glory to God. Glory to God.
Jesus.
Jesus.
And I listened to you when you delivered those two people from Africa and the man from California with his wife.
Right.
And the lady who had the same thing I had, infirmity and the spirit of death,
right,
and demon.
Right.
I listened to you when you did her. And while you're doing her, I was doing it too.
Woo! Do you know? Glory to God.
Jesus.
Do you know the devil fought me on that testimony? He got angry that I posted it, and that lady, she around my age, she allowed, because see, when we get our deliverance, it's up to us to maintain our deliverance.
I saw you said that. I'm going to listen to that next. Yes.
That's very important, because if a person could not lose their deliverance, Jesus wouldn't tell us that once he cast the spirit out, the spirit leaves for a while, but it comes back at a certain time.
To see if
there's a door that it can go through to enter back into you, and it'll bring seven demons more wicked than itself. He wouldn't have told us that.
Yes.
But anyway, that particular testimony, and I'm glad you said that, because that particular testimony, the devil, this lady allowed the enemy, because of her failure to obey God in a certain area. And I know what the area is, because I talked it over with her. And she became angry and wanted me to pull that video off. And she never asked me to, and she tried to accuse me that she did not give me permission to post it.
How did her give you the permission to do it?
And so anyway, she just, that devil through her just threatened me that she was going to go to her one of her relatives who was a lawyer and file a suit. And I said, well, go ahead. I'm looking forward to the challenge.
But did you know that? But her testimony blesses me. Her testimony, you see, what you did for her helped me.
See, it helped you and no telling who else. And see, she could have been, she would have been blessed. Now, your deliverance, God would have credited her your deliverance. He would have gave her
credit.
Because
exactly what you were going through. I said, how could this be, this woman? This woman, when I saw it, I said, oh, I stopped. I said, my God.
Glory to God.
Jesus.
God,
let her know,
so
don't do
good.
That. Tell her, don't pull it. It blesses me. And a lot of people out there, it's going to bless.
And see, now you got a powerful testimony, and the Holy Spirit through you is going to help deliver and set others free.
Thank you.
You got a powerful testimony. When the people who have known that you was in bondage, when they see you now, they're going to know that a transformation have taken place.
Yes.
And your testimony is going to set them free.
Yes, I was going through a lot. My mind was, listen, there was a torment on my mind. You could just hear it. I said, what? I have to hold my head sometimes and hold it tight. I said, what's going on?
Because we need to remember that devils don't work alone. They don't work alone. Yes. They bring others with them. Now, those demons that were tormenting you was spirit of death, spirit of infirmity, spirit of fear, and mental spirits. Those were the demons.
And like it's telling me, it's like it's saying to me, God didn't heal up this cancer, but that's still there. I said, no. The devil is a lie. It is not there. I will not buy that. It's not my portion.
That's right. It's not your portion. No.
Jesus.
Amen. But you see how we must...
Honey, blesses me.
You see how we must place ourselves in a position where we pursue the Lord and keep pursuing him for his help. And as he see that we continue to be faithful in pursuing him, he will look down on us and say, I got to free my child. Got to set my child free.
I said, God, I said, let me be up. Driving my niece to work. My sister died and left my old daughter. And I have her and the son and the granddaughter. Said, Keisha, you know what? I am not going to give up. I'd rather fail with God than fail with man. But I'm not giving up.
That's right.
I said to her Friday.
And God was listening to you. He was listening to you.
I said, God is going to give me that deliverance. Because I said, I'd rather fail with God than fail with man. I'm not giving up. Something got to give.
Jesus, you are so, so good. He was hearing you, and all he had for you to do, now go to the internet, and this is what I want you to do. I want you to key in prayer point for spiritual warfare.
And then
on some of my video, the Lord the one told me to put in certain keywords. Now, he spoke to me when he first asked me to post those video messages on YouTube. He said, I want you to key in these certain videos, and I'm going to have people to key them in also, and they're going to contact you.
Spiritual warfare.
Different keywords he had me to plug into the video, because you can edit the video and add tags. They are called tags. And so the Lord gave me the tags to add in there. And then he said that certain ones, he's going to have them to key in those tags on the internet. And my video going to pop up, because he have a message for them. He want to deliver them. He want to set them free. And they're going to, my video going to come up, and they're going to contact me.
But you know, Evangelist, this is what before my mother passed. She said, Althea, God call you to do ministry. But she said, the devil is fighting you so hard. My mom said it to me. She said, God called you, honey. I said, but you have seven of us. Why would it be me? She said, I don't know, but it's you. I remember saying that to her.
Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Now the Lord says, time now.
You have
a powerful
testimony. You blesses me. When I see you blesses
testimony.
Me. I don't know if you take donation, but I would not mind for a little donation.
We do. Have you been to the website?
No, I don't. No, I have not.
Well,
if you go
back to the YouTube channel.
Yes, ma'am.
And you look at the you click on the feature tab, and you look on the right hand corner. You'll see the website, www.thechildrenmite.org. And also, there's a donate button, because I am a nonprofit 501(c) organization, and YouTube accepted my channel as a nonprofit channel. So that enabled me to have a donation button on my channel. So
also, I can do it with a credit card?
Mm-hmm. You just click on that. You just go to the YouTube channel and look for that donate button. Just click on that donation button, and then it's on a secure server. Your information will be secure, and you just key in your information.
I will do it.
But praise the Lord.
It blesses my spirit.
You have
I'm blessed. Telling you, I'm sitting here usually at this time. I have a shake. I have like a fear. I don't feel that. I'm telling you, last night, I do not feel that.
Those demons are gone. They had to flee. Once the Holy Spirit enlightened you in your spirit with truth, those demons just had to rush out.
Yes.
They rushed up and rushed out. Of your nostril and your mouth. They had to come out.
It was through my mouth. You're right. It was.
Yeah, they had to come out because, see, God, it's hard to even explain it, but God is so awesome. We are spirit, and when the Holy Spirit give us a revelation of who Jesus is, his truth, it's like being in a dark room and all of a sudden just a light come on. That darkness got to flee.
Ma'am.
When the Holy Spirit give us a revelation, an inward knowing of God's word, of Jesus Christ, of truth, that darkness inside us, it comes out. It comes out because the light exposes it and it dispels it. That's why a lot of our sisters and brothers are walking around in bondage now.
Listen, you are so right. Where I live at, I said, God, if I have to move from here in the place, there's some people here, evangelists, they're walking, but it's like a day. They're just breathing. Because they need someone to deliver, and they're so lost.
Right. They are spiritually in the spirit
realm.
In the spirit realm, they are nothing but a walking zombie. I see
it around here, and it bothers me.
Yeah, that spiritually they are dead. They walking zombies. They not of themselves. But in the natural realm, you know, if you look at them physically, they got nice homes, nice cars, nice clothes, a nice job. Yeah. But spiritually speaking, they are dead on the inside. They are dead. They're just a walking zombie. And unless the Lord wake them up, they cannot be awakened. God has to wake them up on the inside. And when the Lord wake them up, this is no lie, you literally hear them say, because that's what happened to me, you literally hear them say, oh, it feel like I've been asleep, and I just woke up. Because that's exactly what happened to me. I shook my head, and I was like, oh, I was asleep. And that was for 10 years that I was spiritually a zombie, where I was a spiritual asleep. And one day God, nothing but his grace and mercy, he woke me up, and I literally said out of my mouth, I shook my head, and I was like, I've been asleep. I'm like, what happened to me? I've been asleep. And that's when the Lord revealed to me what had happened in the spirit.
My God.
And all due to my not continuing in submitting my life to him. I may have submitted in certain areas, but there was other areas that I failed to submit. And you know, Satan, all he need a crack to enter through, and that's it. So
I was like, and I was in, it's like, I was just, when it comes nighttime, it's like a fear of the night. What's going on? when I see good and dark, it's like, oh my gosh.
That dread, that was torment. Yeah, yes. That was the enemy. And there's a lot of our brothers and sisters like that today. But the sad part is, most of them are refusing deliverance. They say, oh, I'm all right. But it's actually not them who's saying they're all right. It's really that demonic spirit.
Yes.
And that is because they're not around the right people. See, Satan tries very hard to keep people who need deliverance to being around the right people who could help them spiritually.
Yes.
You know, they're always around people who can't help them spiritually.
Yes.
You know.
I feel like something come off me, like I was carrying like a ton on my back, and I said, God, I just couldn't do it anymore. Who's going to do this? I've been to so many places. I said, God, if I can't do this right now, how am I going to have somebody else? If you call me to do this, how am I going to do it? I cannot let this fear get a hold of me. Because how am I going to help somebody else if I have this fear I'm carrying? I can't.
You can't.
I got to overcome this. I got to beat this. I keep saying to God, I got to beat this fear.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah, I went to church and I came in yesterday and I lay down and I said, you know what? I just have this phone just going back and forth. I just put it in and you popped up. When I heard you, I said, no, I have to get a computer for her because I was on my phone.
Mm-hmm.
And when I got on my car, I said to my niece, you got to hear this woman. You have got to hear her. So I took her shopping to the grocery store and we came back in. I said, nobody bother me. So I'm getting a new tube on the comment. I'm going to listen to everything she has to say. 3:00 before I got off the phone with you, I was in tune. I said, no, I've got to hear all this, what she got to say.
So where are you originally from?
I am from Jamaica.
Jamaica, okay. I talked with another lady from Jamaica, but she lives in New York.
Oh, I'm in Connecticut. I used to live in, I've been in New York, but I mean, not, but I'm here in Connecticut now, yes.
Yeah. And I think I talked with her about, I think hers was one of them was a spirit of fear as well, and spiritual husband.
Wow.
Yeah.
Because I used to have that a lot.
Mm-hmm.
I know my mom had 7 kids. Another 7 kids, she lost 3.
Mm.
And nobody has ever married. And the one kid who was going to get married, he decided he's going to break. He said, I'm going to break the cycle, my sister, and I'm going to get married. He died. They shot him and killed him.
Whew. Jesus.
I said, what's going on? I said, something is not right with this family.
That's what it was.
Jesus.
Your family roots was your mother, your grandmother, your grandfather, was any of them involved in witchcraft?
You know, that's what somebody's saying, that somebody's telling me years ago that they're saying that somebody on my mother's side, like maybe her father or something, or her they said that he did something, but he never lived to read the repercussion, and it came down on us. That's what somebody was telling me.
Yeah, that was the root call. That's how the enemy entered in that family line, is through some.
See, that's what they're saying. The altar that he made up in Jamaica, the altar was never destroyed, and it's still in the bloodline coming down.
But all it takes is one person to become a Christian, and through the blood of Jesus, that altar is destroyed. By faith, it is destroyed. All it takes is one family member to become a Christian to destroy, by faith, that altar. Mm-hmm. You don't even have to go visit there. It's by faith. You speak it out of your mouth and say, in the name of Jesus, I destroy the altar of Satan that my foreparents worship. By the blood of Jesus, I destroy it. Uprooted by faith, by the blood of Jesus, right now in Jesus' name. And you believe that, and it is done.
Okay,
it's
I got
done.
You.
See, we got real. It's all done by faith. It's by faith.
That those
altars can be torn down and destroyed from the root. You know, whatever plant my heavenly Father has not planted shall be rooted up. That is the ground that you're going to use to tear down that altar, because your heavenly Father wasn't the one who planted that altar. So therefore, it got to be uprooted in Jesus' name. That way, that curse would not go no longer. It's destroyed by the blood of Jesus.
Yeah. Jesus.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah. And these things are good to know the root cause of our problems. It's good to know it so we can destroy the root cause. And also it helps us to teach other people whenever God puts you, in the midst of someone else who maybe family is going through such a turmoil and devastation. And you rely on the Holy Spirit, what is the root cause of this? You know, because you just don't want to just get rid of the symptom. You know how it is sometimes you have a cold, you just get rid of the symptom, but you really haven't got rid of the cold. So after a while,
exactly.
The cold going to come back.
You haven't gotten to the root of it.
Yeah, you destroy the root. And only the Holy Spirit can reveal the root, you know, and once you destroy the root, you know, the symptom's gone and there'll be no more. And like I said, it's good to know the root so we can teach others to maintain their deliverance by destroying that root cause.
Oh, gosh. And then you said something else. You said that when you felt an attack, but it was in your stomach.
Oh, yeah. That was before.
That happened to me. Yeah.
Yeah, that was before the Lord had delivered me. I did not know I had a demon in my body. I didn't know it, and I was saved, and I had been filled with the Holy Spirit with evidence of speaking in tongues too. A person say, "No, you." Yes, I did. I was. I know. You can say whatever you want to say. I know.
I did too.
But I thought God. I really actually thought I was giving God my own, my everything. And what I did do, and I think what helped me to be blessed by God, I pursue Him. I meditate upon Him day and night. I worship Him. I praise Him. You know, I just gave Him my mind. You know, I just pursue Him. And by doing that, I do believe by doing that, God looked down on me with compassion, said, I must totally deliver my child. And so when that woman of God, well, it really was the Lord because it was Him. I heard His voice using her. He said, I have some of you, but I don't have all of you. I was shocked and I was like, huh, what you mean? I thought I was giving you my all. He said, no, I have some of you, but I don't have all of you. And then the lady had put her hand on my stomach. And when she did, now, even though with my eyes closed, I could still see her hand. And matter of fact, I don't think her hand was on my stomach, but it was on my spiritual stomach, but not my physical stomach. That's the way I can interpret.
Yeah.
But anyway, I noticed that when her hand was at my stomach, it was like something got it attention. I mean, that at the time I didn't know it was a demon. I just said it was something. It stood attention. And whenever the lady would move, my eyes was closed now. When I tell this testimony, my husband was standing there watching me. My eyes were closed. And he said, Terry, it happened just as you were saying it. I said, yeah, because it's like I could see it. Even though my eyes were closed, it still was like I could see it. But she began to slowly move her hands up towards my mouth. And I noticed that when she would do that, I literally felt something moving following her hand. If she stopped, then that something stopped. She started, and that something started back. And so she kept going up, and I felt something coming up, and I was like, something is coming up. Follow her hand. Mm-hmm. And so when she got near my mouth, something literally flew out of my mouth, and I heard her say, Derek, go. And then I fell back, and my spirit was crying out, thank you, Jesus, real fast.
But my
mind kept saying, something came out of my mouth. What was it? Something came out of my mouth. But my spirit man was praising and thanking the Lord because my spirit man knew what had happened, but my mind was naive to what had happened. So when I went back home, I thought about it. And so I asked the Lord, I said, Lord, something flew out of my mouth. I said, you didn't take the Holy Spirit from me, did you? Because I knew I received the baptism of the Holy Spirit when He came upon me. So I thought maybe the Lord took him back. See, that's when I was naive. I was naive regarding the scripture. I was still a babe in Christ. I was learning. And then the Lord said, my child, I would never do that. I said, well, what was it, Lord? Something came out of my stomach, out of my mouth. And He said, Terry, it was a demon. And I was shocked. I said, a demon? And then I thought back I was like, that what it was, because about
wow.
I think 7 weeks before the Lord delivered me, I was in my room meditating upon the Lord, and all now I done had three children. You know, my baby at the moment was around 5, and my oldest daughter was around 12, something like that. Yes. So I've been pregnant 3 times. So now I knew how when a baby moves in your stomach, you know, I know when it's a baby, whatever. But I was sitting there, and all of a sudden my stomach moved like there was a baby in it. And I was like, and I looked down at my stomach, and I said, now, I ain't praying, ain't no baby in there. And this is no lie, this voice said, oh,
wow.
It's only me, the Holy Spirit. And then I said, oh, okay. And didn't think nothing of it, because remember now, I was a babe in Christ. I was just learning regarding spiritual matters. So I didn't know. I thought it was the Holy Spirit, like it said it was the Holy Spirit. But then after the Lord freed me, I was like, Lord, that was that demon speaking in my hearing, telling me that it was the Holy Spirit, and it wasn't. And then there was something else that had happened one time before. We was at the kitchen table.
Yes.
And my husband and our children, my parents, and all of a sudden, I was eating, and then all of a sudden, I looked at everybody, and they was looking at me. And my mother and my father were looking at me like, why did you say that?
And my goodness.
But I was so afraid to ask them, what did I say, that I didn't ever ask them. All I knew is I did not remember saying anything. Then I realized that was that demon that had manifested through me and blanked me out and was doing the talking, whatever it said. I never asked him what I said because I was so afraid. But
because,
God,
you know what?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
But God, grace and mercy, he delivered me. He set me free, and that demon had to flee. And I'm going to tell you this too. Right after I received the baptism of the Holy Spirit with evident speaking in tongue, because I refused to receive a false tongue, because I had an aunt when I grew up, she spoke false tongue because she was into witchcraft, and I knew she was of the devil, and everybody thought she was of God. So after I had received the baptism of the Holy Spirit with evident speaking in tongue, I knew that was God. I was aware of everything. I knew it. About a few weeks later, about a few days later, now that demon was still in my body. Now this was before the Lord had set me free from that demon still in my body.
Yes.
Demons are very sneaky. They're very sneaky and cunning and sly. And so the pastor was teaching something. He was speaking. And so I was witnessing to the word. So I noticed when I was witness to the word, it was like the tongues wanted to come up through me. And so the tongues came out of my mouth, and I wasn't the one that was speaking. It literally was speaking in a tongue, but at least I knew that that was not God.
Right.
And so I tried with all my might to stop it. My willpower to stop it, but it kept coming. And so the pastor, he looked at me and he listened. And I believe God allowed that to happen to let me see that pastor wasn't where he should have been. Instead of rebuking that spirit through me, because I could have been, you know what? Thank you, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit just told me that God wanted me to be delivered that night when that demon spoke them tongue. God wanted me to be delivered through the pastor, by the pastor.
Yes.
God wanted to use the pastor to deliver me. But instead, that pastor, I saw him just as good. He stopped. He listened. And I was waiting, like, help me, you know, help me. I had fit myself out. It's like I was crying out to him, help me, because I couldn't stop these tongues. And I knew it was not of God. I knew it wasn't God, but I couldn't stop it. And I kept looking at him like, help me, help me. And there he was listening. And then I felt when he said, oh, that's the Lord. And he walked away.
Wow.
And then I kept resisting, and then as I continued resisting, God had grace and mercy on me, and that demon went down.
Yeah.
And then that's when, I think it was several months later, that's when God set me free. But it never occurred to me until now. I'm talking to you, God wanted to set me free right then through that pastor. But that pastor really was fearful, and he counted them tongues as the Lord when it was not. It was a demon. And I knew it was a demon. I knew it was a demon. And you got a lot of Christian men, Christian women who are speaking in tongues, and those tongues are not of God. They are of the devil. And the only way you know that is if the Holy Spirit reveal it to you. Because when the devil speaks tongues through you, he takes control. You're not the one speaking. It's like something else is speaking through you. The Holy Spirit don't work that way. The Holy Spirit works with you.
Yes.
You two work together.
Yeah.
He brings the other in, but I'm doing the speaking, and I can stop it anytime I get ready.
Exactly. Some people can't do it. You're right.
You see, that's the difference between the devil and the demon's tongues and the Holy Spirit.
Because I've seen people that have to sit down and quiet them. They can.
They can.
I have a friend like that. You cannot, when she starts, you look at, could go till tomorrow. I'm like, what's going on?
Mm-mm. That demon spirit has to be cast out of them.
Okay.
And see, but how the demons deceive the people by whispering to the people, these tongues are of God. You interfere with God.
My goodness. Evangelist King, you blesses me. I can tell you that much. I know I have some little ways to go, but I'm telling you, that fear, oh my, that was my biggest thing. And usually what I notice in life, like I experience a lot of, like, you know, if people promise you they're going to do it for you, nobody comes through. So it's like a spirit of rejection. Like no matter if they're happy to do it, by the time they get to me, it's like, no. All my life I experienced that. I said, God, I know little by little you're going to deliver me from all these things that I'm facing.
And he did too. Praise his own holy name. The Lord don't give up on us, and he don't want us to give up on him. Amen. 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 Cynthia? Hello? Hello? Can you hear me? I can't hear you. Hello? Cynthia? Hello?
Hello?
Okay, we got disconnected.
Yes, I noticed. I said, I said, this is the devil right here. You're not going to let me talk to this lady. I'm talking to her whether you like it or not.
he can't stop it. That's for
sure.
At this point,
he's mad. Yes.
I want to know. I would like to share your testimony on the YouTube channel.
Yes, ma'am.
And I want to know if I can have your permission. I don't share everybody. Yes, just ma'am. That when certain ones where I feel their testimony would really truly be beneficial to the listener. That's what I ask to share.
Everything you did from last night to today, I was involved. Whatever you said, I was saying it. I was involved in everything.
Praise the Lord.
Whoever you were delivered, I was taking that deliverance to. I said, Lord, this is me. I was taking it. Everything you were doing, I did it.
Amen, amen, amen.
Everything you did, I did it. I said, Lord, every which way possible, I need this. I am going to just be like, I took place of the other people. I was like in the middle of it.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. God is, you know, that's the reason why when the Lord tells us to do something, we just need to just do it. You know, just trust Him and being obedient and to do it. Because, you know, like for me, for instance, when I do the video message, you know, I can't see you all. I really don't know who God is going to speak to, but I know He's going to speak to someone, so I must believe it, and I must act as though that it has already happened, or it is happening as I'm doing the video. You see, that's what the Holy Spirit told me to do, and it's by faith. And sure enough, process of time, I get testimonies like you, and they will say, you know, when you said such and such, you were talking to me. Because there have been times where I be speaking, and it literally felt like I'm talking specifically to somebody. And I know the Holy Spirit is talking to somebody, and at His appointed time, He will tune them in.
Yes.
You know, so it's by faith that I believe that I have already received and that God is doing the work. And then when His time comes where I can meet you all face to face, we be together, then that time will come. But until then, I have to be obedient and believe in God without seeing.
My goodness. Mm-hmm. What state are you in?
I'm in North Carolina, Raleigh, North Carolina.
I know Raleigh, North Carolina.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I used to live in Savannah. I know down there.
Okay.
Oh my goodness! I know Raleigh, beautiful town.
Yeah, it is. It really is. We have just moved back here, about going on 3 years.
Yes, I know Raleigh.
We have been living in Baltimore, Maryland for about 10 years.
I know Baltimore. Yeah. Oh my goodness. Mm-hmm.
What do you
worship on Saturdays or Sundays?
But the church we attend now, they worship on Sundays.
Okay.
But we have once attend a church that they worship on Saturdays. So whichever day they choose to worship, it's fine with me. As long as I find a day to worship together.
It's your relationship with God that really counts.
Right. You know, some people like, well, I'm not going to a church who don't worship on Sunday, and I'm not going to a church who don't worship on Saturday. It don't matter.
I don't keep like that either. I keep the Sabbath because, you know, but I something that I chose to do, that I did worship, but there's a time when I did worship on Sunday. And then sometimes on Sundays, too, when people invite me, I go to their church and visit.
Because
it's your relationship with God that really counts.
Right. You're right. You're right about that. Amen. Amen.
Yeah. God don't care about the denomination. He don't.
No. He do not. God looks at the heart of an individual.
Exactly.
The heart.
Exactly.
Amen. I thank Him.
I'm gonna ask you to pray for me before you get off, because you blesses my spirit.
Okay. All right. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I uplift Cynthia. Lord, I thank you. I thank you for your mercy and grace. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for never giving up on her. And I thank you for her never giving up on you, Lord Jesus. Father, I thank you that right now that Cynthia is covered in your blood. And I thank you for the heavenly angels that you got surrounding her and her family, protecting her from all the evils of the wicked one, Father. I thank you, Lord, for giving her freedom in you, Christ Jesus. And Father, I ask you to reveal to her more and more, and to give to her more and more the revelation of your Son, Jesus Christ, Father. Father, I just say thank you for the peace that you have given her from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. I just thank you for forever being with her, for leading her, for guiding her into all truth, revealing your truth more and more to her, Father. I just thank you, Father, that you're going to give her holy boldness that she needs, Father, in order to bring in more souls into your kingdom, Father. Father, I thank you for giving her more revelation of your word, to teaching her, leading, guiding her into all truth. Father, I just thank you. I just thank you for her faithfulness toward you, Lord Jesus. And Father, we give you all the praise and the glory forever and ever in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you so
much. You're welcome. And you have the number. And whenever you feel there's a need, when the Holy Spirit leads, just feel free to call.
Thank you. And I will send you an email. Yes, I will get onto the internet later. Yes.
Yeah. All right. You too. Bye-bye. Hello?
Hi, Evangelist. I'm calling you back to give you another testimony.
Okay. Go ahead.
You just prayed for me a few minutes ago, right?
Uh-huh.
And my niece is standing right here. She's 24 years old. She's on that line. I went in the bathroom and I vomited up a lot of blood come out of my stomach, like a lot of mucus of blood just came right in. And I felt like, I felt a relief in my belly.
Uh-huh. Right.
Oh, my God. A lot of mucus came up. There was blood come up with the mucus. Like, I felt something in my stomach move. I'd move from my belly to my chest, and it come right up. When I opened my mouth, I just start vomiting.
What that is, that's spiritual poison.
Jesus.
Yeah.
I said, Father God, you remember you said anything in my heavenly Father's not planted should get rooted?
Right.
I start saying that any marine deposit in my body, anything in my heavenly Father's not planted, it should come out.
Amen. Amen.
And I thought my niece would tell you she couldn't believe it.
What?
She was knocking my back, and I went over the tub and I sat there and I vomited up every mucus come out with blood with it. And I know I'm not. I felt like $1 million.
That's spiritual poison. Spiritual Jesus. Poison. Where the enemy was planning. He really was planning on taking you out, killing
yes.
you.
Yes.
Yeah, he really was. He planted a lot of diseases and sickness in your body.
Because I told you, I kept seeing the spirit of, like, a spirit of death. The devil is alive. I know this man prayed for me when he prayed. It's like, but when I got on with you yesterday, oh, mm-hmm. my God, everything mm-hmm. started taking place.
Jesus.
I said, this woman of a clean spirit, her spirit is clean. That's why I connect with mine.
Amen, amen, amen. Jesus. And see, those are the people.
I get a lot of help. I got a lot of help, and nothing happened. I said, this woman's spirit is clean, Keisha, because it connects with my spirit.
See, those are the people that you want God to use and laying hands on you are people
yes.
with a clean spirit. If you get people who don't
yes.
have a clean spirit, when they lay hands on you, all is happening is that demon in them is transferring an evil spirit onto you.
That's what was happening to me, I think.
Right.
Because I wasn't getting no better. I
right.
said, honey, this woman's spirit is clean because it connected to mine last night. Your spirit connected. I don't know. I said, you have a clean spirit.
Amen. Amen. We pray God raise up men and more who have clean spirits so that they can help God's people get set free. That's why we need each other. We need one another. Where you may be strong and I may be weak, then you can help me and vice versa.
Thank you. All right.
You see, that's how it's supposed to be. We're not supposed to be, you know, coming against each other and falsely
yes,
accusing one
yes.
another. And when we do err, we're taking, you know, a cursing to the fire and condemning them more and more. No. You're supposed to restore
yes,
them.
Yes,
restore your brother.
Yes.
Restore your sister. So I thank God that he's continued to clean out all of that spiritual poison that the enemy had
yes.
injected into
yes.
your body.
And it came through sex, because every time I drink the spirit, I look come and lay with me and I get up and I feel so filthy. I used to get so mad.
That's why. Praise the Lord. And you got your niece there witness. She witnessed that poison coming out of
she
you.
She witnessed it. And the 8-year-old was there too. They were both knocking my back. They couldn't believe it. I run past them in the kitchen and run straight to the bathroom.
Glory to God. Thank you,
Jesus.
That girl, God gonna use you mightily.
Thank you, God. Thank you.
Mightily to bring souls into his kingdom. And always remember now, no
yes,
weapon.
Yes.
And when he start using you, remember, no weapon that the enemy form
yes.
will be successful in what it set out to do against you. Lord said, no weapon. So,
yes.
so you just keep your heart and mind on the Lord and
yes.
be determined
yes,
and adamant about the things
yes.
of God not giving up, going
Yes,
bold and
ma'am.
strong for his
Yes.
sake, because this is a
Yes, ma'am.
spiritual battle, and what you're doing for Jesus' sake,
Yes.
and Jesus
Yes.
will back you up as long as you stay in his word. See, Jesus all only
Yes.
he only backs up his word. As long as we stay in the word, Jesus got our back.
Yes, thank you so much.
Thank you for giving that testimony. Praise
God
the
bless
living
you.
God.
Thank you. God bless.
I tell you.
To God be the glory. Thank you.
To God be. It's nobody but him. And see what
yes,
he
ma'am.
Needs. He needs us to open our mouth to speak.
Yes.
So whatever
yes,
we speak
yes.
on earth,
yes.
then he'll bring it to pass in heaven.
Yes.
You know,
Jesus.
If we speak on earth what's done in heaven, because there's no sickness in heaven.
Yes.
So if we're speaking,
yes.
speaking on earth, he would do it. So he just need us to be obedient because we are his body.
Yes.
And he
yes.
only moves when we move. He only act when we act. So, but we must do it by faith. It's just
yes,
a simple, just simple believing. You know, I know we've been taught you
yes.
ever have. A whole lot of faith, but ain't no such thing.
Yes.
Faith is faith. Faith is believing.
Yes.
It's just believing. Believing
Jesus.
What Jesus said he would
yes.
do. He would do it. Everything Jesus said in his word is believing. I choose to believe it.
Yes.
That's all. That's all it is. Just believe in the Lord.
Yes. God bless you. To God be the glory.
Amen.
Thank you.
You're welcome. You're welcome. Thank you for giving me that testimony.
Yes, honey. God bless you.
You too. All right. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.